Well, Trace Gallagher says this is the story of the day. We are just now learning what happened a couple of months back when a down-on-her-luck widow went to sell a treasured souvenir. It was a very small moon rock given to her late husband by astronaut Neil Armstrong. And unbeknownst to her, that is apparently a federal crime. Trace Gallagher following this wild story from our West Coast Bureau. What happened to this woman, Trace?
This, by the way, this moon rock is the size of a grain of rice, Megan, and it's not like the feds got this big tip. This woman was trying to fence this stolen moon rock. Joanne Davis says she was trying to raise some money for her sick kid, right? And she was trying to leave her kid some inheritance. She's 74 years old, so what does she do? She calls NASA, and she emails them saying, hey, I've got this moon rock. I'd like to sell it. Can you help me find a buyer? It was given to me by my husband. He says Neil Armstrong gave it to him. NASA, not only do they help her, they set up a sting operation on her. And they agree to buy this rock for $1.7 million, and they agree to meet at this nefarious little hideaway called Denny's. And Joanne and her new husband get to this Denny's. They pull out the moon rock. And what happens? Six sheriff's deputies and five NASA agents run in. They grab her. They pull her out of this Denny's. She said she's so scared that she lost control of her bladder. They took her outside and questioned her for 2 hours. She went on to say, and I'm quoting, it's very upsetting. It's very detrimental. Very humiliating. It's all a lie. NASA, for their part, says, look, the inspector general works to arrest anybody who goes out to sell or steal moon debris. Over the years, by the way, NASA has gotten rid of about 2,200 of these things. They give them to heads of state, countries. They've lost count of about 400 or lost them altogether. But NASA says they do not belong to people. These are supposed to be a part of the government. And Neil Armstrong, by the way, says, I didn't give it to the guy. He went on record saying, I never gave anybody a moon rock.
Oh, really?
So the husband died 20 years ago, 30, 25
thickens.
Years ago. So we can't ask him, right?
Poor Joanne. What a scene in the local Denny's.
She's 4 feet 11. 4 feet 11, by
How
the way,
old is she?
They pulled her out of there. 74.
Nice. Okay. Thanks, Trace. Yeah.
California okay. woman wanted to sell a tiny piece of moon rock, a moon rock dust that she's owned for nearly 40 years.
And it could actually be worth, get this, more than $1 million. She tried to make that deal in May, and then she was confronted by government agents. National correspondent Ben Tracy has more on the story that is really now just coming to light.
We just walked over.
74-year-old California grandmother Joanne Davis thought she was going to her local Denny's for a simple business transaction. But then it got ugly.
And I get in. Someone is grabbing me from the back. Now they're pulling me out of the booth, and they have a hold of me pretty darn good. And the force was like unnecessary in my part because I'm like 110. I'm 4'11".
She expected to sell a tiny speck of moon rock encased in a paperweight she claims was given to her space engineer husband 40 years ago. But after she contacted NASA to see if they could help her find a buyer, federal agents set up a sting at this Denny's. They suspected she was dealing in stolen government property.
It's not stolen. I know it, and they know it too. But how else are they going to credit themselves with how they took it? I mean, how do they justify it?
NASA declined to comment on an ongoing investigation. Yet 5 months after being detained and questioned for 2 hours, Davis still hasn't been charged with anything.
There's no such law that moon rocks belong to the federal government. There are laws about stealing from the federal government, and I understand that. And if anybody could show that these moon rocks were stolen from the federal government, that's a horse of a different color. But they haven't shown that.
Davis claims the agents bruised her arm and tailbone during the incident, but the emotional wounds are far worse.
I mean, I felt humiliated. I felt, this may not be proper to say, but I'll tell you, I felt raped. I really did.
At this point, Davis simply wants NASA to return what she feels is her property, but she does have an attorney, and they're considering legal action of their own. Ben Tracy, CBS News, Los Angeles.
During the conference, I asked Buzz Aldrin about the recent Dutch moon rock incident. In 1969, during their goodwill tour, the Apollo 11 crew gave a moon rock to the then ambassador to the Netherlands, J. William Middendorf, who in turn presented it to former Dutch Prime Minister Willem Dries. My and Aldrin's exchange was very civil and very peaceful.
Yeah.
I have a few questions I would like to ask, if I may. Firstly, as I'm sure you might have read in the newspapers recently, a moon rock that was on display in a Dutch museum, which you, Neil, and Mike had given to the then ambassador to the Netherlands at the time, it turned out to be a piece of petrified wood. I was wondering, at the time, when you were in possession of this, were you aware that this was petrified wood, or were you also led to believe that it was a genuine moon rock?
Petrified wood. Well, that doesn't sound like it came from the moon. The samples that we, as best I can recall, that we distributed among world leaders in our 45-day around-the-world trip were encased in plastic lucite so that you could see the small amount of moon dust. Mm-hmm. Now, what happens to that display once it is presented to somebody is not the responsibility of the United States, and it certainly isn't the responsibility of the crew that gave it to them. And whether that got changed, substituted for something that then became valuable to someone else, and they substituted a piece of petrified wood, that would be my more probable explanation for this. Now, who did that? We have no idea. But I'm sure the United States would not present to world leaders a piece of petrified wood claiming that it was a sample from the moon.
Okay, so you're telling me that you give these samples out to the people and someone swapped it around after you gave it to the world leader properly?
Well, that's my best guess. But it's a guess. I have no information at all.
Okay. My second...
I know that I had a watch that I wore on the moon.
Buzz, I've got a question for you, actually.
An Omega watch.
If I.
And it was missing. But it's considered stolen property. And if you have access to stolen property, you don't advertise it around until the right time you figure out how to dispose of it.
Okay.
Because you'll be accused of stealing or harboring stolen property. It makes things kind of complicated.
Surprising discovery, water on the moon, 100 times more of it than scientists ever suspected. Nearly 40 years after the last Apollo moon landing in 1972, scientists are still studying rocks brought back by the astronauts. And it turns out they contain just as much water as similar rocks here on Earth.
Who's to know if your soul will fade at all? One you sold to fool the world. You lost your self-esteem along the way. Yeah.
Good God, you're coming up with reasons. Good God, you're dragging it out. Good God, it's the changing of the seasons. It feels so ranked. So follow me down and just fake it. If you're out of direction, fake it. If you don't belong.
And it turns out they contain just as much water as similar rocks here on Earth. Similar rocks here on Earth. Here on Earth.